Hey, this is Red Band coming to you live from the World Famous Comedy Store main room for a brand new episode of Kill Tony. Get up at Tony.
Hi, everybody. Hello. Make some noise. You're the number one live podcast in the world. How exciting. Brian, Red Band is here.
What is up, everyone?
Holy smokes. I am so excited to be back here again after a fun week in the belly room last week. It's good to be back in the main room. You guys excited about this or what? Josh Martin is here. We just had a fun weekend in Spokane. He was killing, featuring for me there. Fun times. Right, Josh?
Yeah.
Fuck yeah. There you go. The Kill Tony Machine is going to Las Vegas, Nevada this Friday. Isn't that exciting?
Can't wait.
Vegas gets their first ever Kill Tony, and then San Fran the week after that. Well, that's already sold out, actually. So you lost out on that one. But there's stand-up shows that weekend with me doing headlining shows, and Jeremiah's with me, and Red Band on Saturday, and I think Ali Makovsky on Friday. Fun stuff happening there. Boston, Massachusetts, I'm doing stand-up there. We have our five-year anniversary of Kill Tony, yeah. June 18th. I think, I might be wrong, but I think there's still tickets available for that.
Yeah.
Fort Wayne, Indiana, Kill Tony on August. And then I realized today... We're doing those three shows in Texas, Kill Tony, in the month of September. Three shows in Michigan, Kill Tony, in September. That's six extra episodes that the listeners of the show are going to get for the month of September. Hey, Dom Irrera! He's going to be here for the five-year anniversary with Joe Rogan on June 18th. Dom, what the hell are you doing here? You just hanging out? All right.
Free parking.
Well, if you want to come hang out and plop up here at any point, you let me know. Or you could hang out, do whatever you want. The great and powerful Dom Irrera, one of the greatest comedians in the world. Just swinging by, just saying hello. Number 37 on Comedy Central's greatest comedians of all time. I fucking love it.
Six more episodes of Kill Tony. That's ridiculous.
Yeah, that's 10 episodes in the month of September.
Jesus.
What lucky listeners we have. And you know... The five-year anniversary coming up as well. You know, time goes fast. Oh, yeah. Breaking news. The new and second ever brand spanking new Kill Tony shirt just went on pre-sale right now.
Yeah.
Literally, the link went live right now.
And I designed it with a special nod to the Comedy Store, who's been our home for 5 years. It's an awesome shirt. Check it out.
You're going
to
love it.
Yeah.
Paying homage to the Comedy Store, the best comedy club on the planet, the great Mitzi Shore. You know, time flies. And, you know, when you start to notice hair loss, it's already too late. It's easier to keep the hair you have than to replace the hair you've lost. And that's why with ForHims.com, it's a one-stop shop for hair loss, skincare, sexual wellness for men. Thanks to science, baldness can be optional. ForHims.com connects you with real doctors and medical-grade solutions to treat hair loss. You know a bit about this.
Yeah, everyone knows in the past I used to always go to gas stations and get boner pills. Well, now you don't have to do that. You could actually go to this website and get connected to a real doctor. You don't have to go to a doctor's office. That's embarrassing. You just do it through this website. Next thing you know, you have generic Viagra, and it's like $30 a month. That's way cheaper than those boner pills that might work or might kill you. You know?
That's true. You can go to ForHims.com, and if you order now, our listeners get a free trial month of ForHims.com for just $5 right now while supplies last. See website for full details. This would cost hundreds if you went to the doctor or a pharmacy. Instead, go to ForHims.com/KillTony. That's ForHims.com/KillTony. ForHims.com/KillTony. There you go. Pretty exciting stuff.
Are you still using the hair stuff?
Yes, I love it. It's very good. I take the daily gummy multivitamin.
Yes.
And it's actually, out of all the gummy vitamins that I've ever had, the most delicious.
It is actually pretty good.
It's actually
good.
A real treat to have it. Mm-hmm. You know, it's hard to find good things in this world.
There really is.
Including great talent. But ZipRecruiter knew there was a smarter way, so they built a platform that finds the right job candidates for you. ZipRecruiter learns what you're looking for, identifies people with right experience, and invites them to apply to your job.
These invitations have revolutionized how you find your next hire. In fact, 80% of employers who post a job on ZipRecruiter get a quality candidate through the website in just one day. And ZipRecruiter just doesn't stop there, Tony.
It doesn't?
No, it doesn't. They do a lot more.
What do they do?
They even spotlight the strongest applications you receive so you never miss a great match. The right candidates are out there, and ZipRecruiter is how you find them.
Businesses of all sizes trust ZipRecruiter for their hiring needs. And right now, our listeners can try ZipRecruiter for free. Make some noise for that, huh? For free. Just go to ZipRecruiter.com/KillTony. That's ZipRecruiter.com/KillTony. ZipRecruiter.com/KillTony. ZipRecruiter, the smartest way to hire.
I love it. I actually had my friend found a job on that really easily.
Nice. And I have a couple friends, unlike you, that hang out with mostly employees of jobs. I have a few friends that actually own companies, and they found hires. They found hires from having ZipRecruiter.
Well, yeah, I should maybe hire some people for my company.
Yes,
Tony.
That's true. I know. I knew you would take that as a low blow when it really wasn't. Clearly a joke about how I hang out with important people. Speaking of important people, we have an awesome guest here tonight.
We sure do.
He is one of our favorite guests on the show. I always bring out one of the best comedians in the world. And this week is absolutely no different. A real fucking, like me, a real store guy, came up as an employee, paid a ton of dues all at once, and, fucking turned into a real monster comedian. He's one of our funniest friends. You know him from The League, from a bunch of great movies. Put your hands together for the great Steve Ranazzisi. Oh, shit. Yeah. He's back. Hell yeah. Steve Ranazzisi is back, swinging through before he goes to Charlotte in a couple weeks. Comedy Zone.
Yes.
I was just on your podcast a few months ago, Hear Me This Book, which I love.
I put a pause on it.
Yeah?
Yeah. People like books, but not that much.
Yeah.
And I'm having a good time doing it. It's just getting guests every single week, so I'm reformatting it. Mm-hmm. I think I'm going to have one single guest every month that tells me about their favorite book, a huge guest. And then me read a book once a month and have someone interview me about, like a book report, me doing it to them.
Yeah.
Twice a month. So it'll be a 2 times a month thing. But it's being reformatted. Not that any of you guys listen to begin with. Because people don't like a lot of books.
Well, you know, they might not just like podcasts about books. Perhaps you should write a book about books and have a podcast about
too
podcasts.
Too much work. Out. Hard pass. No thank you.
It's true.
Not writing a book.
It is hard work. Imagine having to sit next to this guy every week.
Jesus Christ. What's up, Red Man?
Hi.
I miss you, buddy.
Thank you, buddy.
Those are great glasses.
I'm filming you.
Yeah, this is a new Snapchat. Yeah, what's that called, Brian?
Snapticles or something. I don't give a shit.
Snapticles from Snapchat. They film live.
How is your vision actually coming out? Like, how do you see things? Forget how...
It's just like normal sunglasses, except I see this record light.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, that would freak me out.
It's weird.
Fuck yeah. So everything is here. You're back. Did you know we have a crazy band that performs every week? They're the best damn band in the land. Every week they commit to different characters. I never know what they're going to do, and they try to stay in character throughout the show while having fun, while we meet comedians. So let's see what they do this week. Make some noise, everybody. It's the Kill Tony Band, the best damn band in the land. Jeremiah Watkins, Joelberg, Joel Jimenez, and Chroma Chris. Here we go. All right. What are they going to be this week?
Oh! Westworld.
Wow, I believe we've seen these characters before. These are, I believe, what are they? Wild West characters from, like, the future or something.
It's Westworld.
Right?
Yeah, it's from Westworld. I think we're very Westworld.
Wow.
And let me tell you, I'm going to fuck all these robots.
Wow. Wow, look at Jeremiah. This is what the yodeling boy is going to look like when he grows up. And then we have Chroma Chris, who's a young version of the bad guy from Poltergeist. And then we have transgender Pocahontas back there. I'm pretty excited about it.
These guys just picked me up at the Home Depot.
Congratulations.
Jeremiah, how you doing over there? What do I call you? Is that your name?
Mighty swell, Tony.
Wow.
That's how I'm doing, that is.
How was your trip here today? Wait, what?
I'm sorry.
Oh, no.
I'm sorry.
Oh, hey, Chris, give him a little whack on the back or something there. There we go.
Freeze all motor functions.
Yeah.
Man, it's always fun until you find out the character already has a knack for being annoying.
My name's Tony Hinchcliffe.
Oh, wow. How are you, breaking character there? What kind of broke-ass Teddy Ruxpin is that?
How was that?
Whoa. You just put the saxophone over your hat?
I have complete functions as a host now.
Oh, what? Well, we saw how that went a few episodes ago, so. All right. All the pieces are in place. I have the bucket of destiny here. Oh, shit. What is he? All right. I have the bucket of destiny with over a ton of comedians' names here signed up tonight.
Craig's bucket of destiny.
Okay. It's Ichabod's bucket of destiny.
His name is Craig. It was revealed in another episode.
I'm under the impression that it sort of hurts his feelings if we call him Craig. I think he likes going by Ichabod.
Does not sound cool.
Well, Beetlejuice doesn't like being called by his name.
What's Beetlejuice's real name?
Philip.
All right. So if I pull your name out of the bucket, you get 60 seconds. You know your 60 seconds is up when you hear the sound of a kitten. That means wrap it up then, or else you're going to bring out the angry West Hollywood bear. Perfect. Here we go. You guys ready to start this shit or what? We're into it. Steve Ranazzisi. The Westworld Kill Tony.
Yes.
Brian Redband. All right. Your first comedian getting an uninterrupted 60 seconds tonight goes by the name of Kiana Marquez. Or Marquez. Kiana Marquez. Here she comes. I love this. Taking the shortcut. Hell yeah. Put your hands together for Kiana, everybody.
Hey, everybody. How's it going? Just because I've hit three things and have gotten maybe three tickets does not mean I'm a bad driver. I'll tell you who's a bad driver. My sister. Well, she died before she can get her license. It's fine, it's fine. You don't know my sister. I love her so much. I honestly think about her every day, but I don't think I would think about her as much as I do if I didn't have her name tattooed right above my pussy. I know a lot of you guys are like, prove it. You wanna see? A lot of people think it's really weird that I have my sister's name tattooed right there. But the way I look at it is every time I get some D, so does she. Thank you. I'm Kiana Marquez.
Wow. Holy shit.
Fuck.
You made a fan over there. That dude lit the fuck up.
Right.
I've never seen someone. He was like, not on board the whole time.
Fuck.
And then you were on board very much at the end, sir. Right? Very much so at the end. Verbally, that was good, he said.
Hi. Uh-huh.
Hello, how are you? This is your first time on the show, right?
Yes, it is. Very nervous.
How long have you been doing stand-up?
7 months.
Wow, seven months. Are you from L.A.?
Ventura.
Ah, interesting. Mm-hmm. And I was distracted for a second. Where did you say you have your sister's name tattooed?
Right above my pussy.
Is that true?
Yeah.
Really? Oh, my God, there it is. Holy shit.
Wait,
how do we know your pussy's still there, though? It could be in a different spot. Right? I mean, who knows? Everyone's different.
You have
to see the whole thing.
I might not have one either. I don't know.
Just there. For posterity, the Cowboys in this side of the room could not see that.
I'm sorry.
Oh. Zoinks.
I'm there so rude. Go. I'm sorry.
My sister died of dysentery.
Wow.
What was your sister's name again?
Savannah.
Prove it.
Prove it.
Holy shit.
Oh my God.
Shit.
Yeah.
Ironic, Savannah is right above a peach.
Well, Savannah's a very dry place.
Wow. Oh my God.
I think that's the Sahara.
Same shit.
Wow.
I got four hymns at my house.
Okay, Brian, stop it right now. I knew you couldn't hold on.
You didn't get that tattoo for the bit, did you?
No, I got it when I was like 15.
Now, okay. Is that a scratch and sniff tattoo?
It can be.
That's an illegal tattoo. We're going to have to remove it tonight. You got it underage.
Okay, so let's just jump right into this. Okay. So how long have you had the tattoo for?
I got it when I was 15. I'm 26 now. I have to do math? Fuck.
How old was the man that performed this tattoo on you?
I have no idea.
Wait, so...
I got it in Oxnard.
A parent signed off on that tattoo?
My mom took me.
What a good mother.
Wow.
Did your sister really pass away?
Yes,
and
when I was 13.
Your mom was like... You're going to get your sister's name tattooed? And
well,
you were like, yes.
I wanted it like really bad. I wanted to get a tattoo.
Sure.
And I kind of, like,
you did.
Convinced my mom to take me to get a tattoo.
Yep. And then how did we decide the location of the tattoo? Was it a committee thing or did you just go, hey, Zach,
okay, so
make it big and put
I
it above my pussy?
Somebody...
The county of Ventura took a vote.
They did.
It's the size of a billboard.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's huge. Well, I really wanted a tattoo. I was really into tattoos at the time.
But what made you pick that area specifically?
I saw somebody have it, and I just thought it was... like.
Who'd you see have it?
I saw somebody from Rock of Love. You remember that show?
Oh, my God.
Where you get all your great ideas. Where all great ideas came from.
I love the honesty,
this girl, Kiana. This girl had, like, a tattoo right here, and I was like, that's so sexy. And I was, like, 13, and I, like, wanted a tattoo there. And after my sister died, I was like, I'm going to get her name right here.
Wow. So let me ask you this. Have you ever had, like, a one-night stand where, you know, maybe you didn't get to talk about the...
Savannah?
Right, about the old dead sister thing, and then all of a sudden they see that, and then what do they think?
Multiple guys as well as, like, doctors when they're, like, pap smear, they're like, who's Savannah? And I'm like...
Wait, doctors?
You fuck doctors?
Oh, no! like I've had, like a pap smear.
Do guys aim for it?
Okay,
probably.
Brian, that is enough. You've already reached
your
maximum limit.
I would if I was a guy.
Of course they do.
I would.
That joke brought to you by ZipRecruiter.com.
No. I literally tried to stop that. Like, no! Fuck.
There goes your sponsor, bro.
Thank God for post-episode editing. Wow. So... Okay, when you said multiple guys have noticed it, like, how many, if you had to guess the number, how many guys have been like, hey, what's up with the chick's name above your pussy?
I have, like a number?
Sure. Hey, why is this guy answering? Is this your boyfriend?
You know.
Four.
Just go with four, he's telling her.
This guy wants you to just live his imagination out all the way for him.
I need you to be perfect for me. Say four.
Or he's calling a golf shot, he's trying to aim for it.
Your name's not Savannah, is it, sir? God almighty.
No, that's Georgia.
What was the question?
Her story's funny when you put it, but not the way she put it together
right.
in front of
yeah.
all of us.
For the joke to work, I think you have
bit.
To show the tattoo. I think
yeah,
people are going to find
bit,
it unbelievable.
I've done the bit so many times, and like it got so repetitive, and like finally I did a show, and I did that bit, and I was like, I'm tired of doing the bit. But I really wanted to do the bit today, you know,
right.
but I forgot it, so that was why I was all like, all over the
well,
place.
Well, we're going to remember it.
I know.
Wow. I mean,
you should hear her other material. What's more alarming is her brother's name above her butthole.
That was good.
It's interesting. Things really took a turn during your set. When I first saw you, you sort of reminded me of the of that one chick that likes stevia in her tea from Breaking Bad. Best if they answer the question first. All right, forget it. That's what we call a train wreck. You ever see one of those? Kiana.
Yes.
So what else about you? What do you do for work?
I'm a biller. A biller? A rehab.
Huh. Yeah.
Medical insurance.
Oh.
I do like collections. I make sure we get paid.
Right.
For rehab.
Yes.
Huh. Interesting. That must be a tough gig, right?
Yeah. I love my job, though. It's awesome. They feed me.
That's it? That's all your qualifications for an awesome... Do they pay you as well?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, they pay me really well. But, like, I get fed all day, so I, like, never have to spend money on food.
What a great life. I mean...
Wow. I'll feed you on the farm. No problem.
How'd your sister die?
She was born with cystic fibrosis.
What's that?
It's a lung disease.
Really?
Yeah.
It's just because we learned something.
Oh, my goodness. Well, all right, Kiana.
Yes.
Was she older or younger?
She was older.
Yeah?
Yeah, but there's a lot more about me than my dead sister. I mean, I was always growing up, I know that's what my bit was about, but now this is about me.
If you have other subjects tattooed under your sister's name, we'd be interested to hear more about that. All right, Kiana. Well, it was a pleasure meeting you.
Nice to meet you.
Fun
Thank
times.
You.
Nice there she
you.
Goes. Kiana Marquis, Kiana Marquez, or as you'll all remember her, Savannah.
I squirted.
Yeah?
All over myself. Oh, yeah. She got me fucking hot, bro.
My goodness. Joelberg, how you doing back there?
Happy to be here, Tony.
Joelberg, all right. I pulled a name out of the bucket. Put your hands together for MJ Graham. Here we go. Another guy, person from the deepest corner. Wow. Here he comes. MJ Graham.
Just taking his time.
Yeah. MJ definitely doesn't stand for Michael Jordan. He's a slow walker. MJ Graham.
Oh, shit. All right. So I got off the phone with my dad recently, and he replied with... All right, dickwad. I woke him up in the middle of the night. He has a sleep apnea machine. But it dawned on me. That's all I am. A dickwad. You know, that's all we all are, dickwads, if you think about it. And it made things worse. My dad had a vasectomy before I was born. So I'm an unwanted dickwad. So, this one's for all the people who... this one's for all the people who... carry their bag of whatever in their mouth from the kitchen to their couch like it hasn't been touched by some snotty-nosed kid or in the armpit of some bum who couldn't purchase it and had to put it back. Comedy Store. Gotta love the Comedy Store, right? One night I saw Uncle Joey in the belly room, and I ran into Carlos Mencia on the way out, and I said, it's good to see you here, man. You know, because he could be kind of running in here right now, shooting at Steve.
Wow. Wow.
Hello. Woof. Way to save yourself with a Carlos Mencia reference.
It's a true story. That's a true story. I should have led with that one. But
what was a true story? I followed 0% of that.
Yeah.
When you were dedicating it, I didn't know who we were dedicating to, and then we were at the Comedy Store.
It was the first. A little fun fact: today, my mom texted me congratulations and reminded me that today is actually my 11-year anniversary of coming here to the Comedy Store to do stand-up, and I want to say that in 11 years of continuously working in the comedy industry, I have never in my life seen anyone dedicate a joke before you do the joke. This next one is for...
But he never did the joke.
Yeah, it never happened.
Just did the dedication.
At one point he goes, what was it? Like, this is... you guys know how you carry a
bag
in your
mouth
whatever.
To the bathroom?
You know, when you
to
carry
the kitchen,
something...
To the couch.
I'm trying to follow the space work.
If you think about it,
there's a
gross.
Lot of whatever, whatever. It's almost like you read, like, a comedy book, but didn't fill in the blanks. Like, you just read the blanks.
Yeah.
Like, and then to say the whatever to the whatever, and then make up a punchline here, and you're just like...
Do you read Mad Magazine and just leave the blanks blank?
Nah, I really thought about it. It's gross if you think about it. People put bags in their mouths and...
What bags?
What bags?
A bag of whatever. Like
a bag
chips,
of whatever? What
chips,
does that mean
chips,
to you? Where do you see people
gummy
with...
Gummy bears or whatever. Like when you carry something in your mouth, it's kind of gross.
From the kitchen to the couch.
Yeah.
Why would anybody ever carry it in their mouth?
I don't
What's
know.
In
I
your hands?
A drink? I don't know.
A drink?
A drink? Okay.
You rolled the cup with two hands?
How many drinks do you have?
You have a fucking sippy cup, MJ?
Nah, it was, I don't know. I saw.
Why would you carry a bag of candy in your mouth from the kitchen to the couch?
I'm jerking off with my other hand, obviously. One hand for cranking, one hand for my thirsty drink,
Tony,
and a bag in my mouth.
Tony, this guy looks like Gooey CK.
There he is. He has arrived. I love how he plays his own rim shots insane after a good one. For those of you listening to the podcast, I turned around and drumsticks were flying in the air during that as he
feels good.
Ricky Borky Borky.
Wow. So, MJ, how long have you been on stand-up?
I started in February.
Started in February.
It's my third time on stage.
Your third time on stage. Next we're averaging.
No, I just started a new job. I couldn't come up here.
We're averaging one spot a month, MJ. I don't know about your pacing on this.
I just started a new job. I couldn't come up here unemployed.
What's the new job?
Burger Lounge.
Burger Lounge. Wow, that's interesting.
You looks like what you eat and do.
Man.
Fucking Joelberg.
What do you do at the Burger Lounge?
Front of house.
Just front of the house.
What, Mr. Yeah. Personality at the top of the at the door?
Yeah, the cashier.
Do you carry the menus in your mouth when you're walking the people to the table from the host stand?
Yeah, what are they making you carry?
Me right this way. Oh.
Don't forget your to-go bag. Mm.
Carry that to wherever, whatever, you know, whatever, anyway. MJ, where are you from?
Upstate New York.
Upstate New York. How long
apart?
You been?
Let's get specific. I went to school in upstate New York.
Horseheads?
Oh, never heard of it.
Horseheads?
Elmira.
Oh, yeah. All right, cool.
My father was buried in Horseheads.
MJ, how long you been in Los Angeles?
Just over a year.
Just over a year. Wow. What were you doing for work before Burger Lounge?
I was a PA last year, so I have an entertainment business degree. That's why I moved out here.
Entertainment business degree from Horsets University.
No. And before that, he made his living as an animated meatball.
Oh, Jesus, what are you talking about?
I take it. Yeah.
MJ, what are some things that you're into? You have any fun? You have any fun hobbies or anything like that?
Yeah, I play softball.
You play softball?
Basketball. Sports.
Basketball? Wow, how often do you play softball?
A couple times a week.
A couple times a week?
Yeah. What are you, like a ringer?
What?
You just pick you up on different teams?
Pick up the human meatball?
Can pick him up.
I used to play.
Do you have a game after this? That's why you're all dressed up?
Yeah. You
too, right? I love it. MJ, how long have you been playing softball for?
I played baseball my whole life, but yeah.
Played baseball your whole life, and then you hit the age where you had to make the old switch, huh?
Became a lesbian.
I still got a couple years of collegiate eligibility, but
fuck yeah.
A couple of Kenny Powers.
MJ, how do you do your hair like that? Do you have a convertible and you just fucking let it rip? I mean, what is that?
Nah, just after the shower, just do this.
Wow.
How many times have you been struck by lightning?
None.
Hmm. You have a girlfriend?
Nope.
No. Last date you went on, what was that like?
We're all friends here, don't worry.
Friday night.
What?
Tinder date Friday night.
You had a Tinder date on Friday night?
Yeah.
How'd that go?
You know, picked her up, brought her back.
What? Wait, you gotta fill in other words, dude.
That fast?
Brought her back to where?
Yeah, so I picked her up from her house.
Picked her up, murdered her, brought her back.
Yeah, sounds like a kidnapping. No,
all the good stuff on a date.
She's on ice in my living room.
So you picked her up? What kind of car do you have? What'd you pick her up in?
Impala.
Impala?
Fuck yeah, you did. Wow. Look at that haircut.
Impaled her.
With the moonroof.
Do you have one of those combs that you put your finger in, you can go back like this with that?
No, I don't have any comb. I just do it with my fingers.
Oh, does
what?
That's true. True story.
Wow, that just shocked the hell out of me.
I know. It does look combed. It looks manicured.
So you picked the girl up in your Impala. Where'd you take her? Straight back to your place?
Yep.
Wow.
What's that look like?
Yeah. What does your place look like?
It's a townhouse.
Outhouse.
I clean it with
townhouse. Oh, I thought you said outhouse. So I was like, makes sense.
It's a townhouse?
It's a townhouse.
Yeah.
How many people do you live with?
I have a roommate.
You have a roommate. Huh, what's your roommate do?
He's a consultant. He's out of town all week, so never see him.
Perfect.
Wow.
Yeah.
So you brought her back to your place, then what happened?
You know, I threw on a movie on Netflix.
What was the movie?
It was Gangs in New York.
Wow.
Perfect. Romantic.
Wow. Romantic as fuck.
Let's keep this dangerous,
nothing,
sweetheart.
Nothing.
I didn't pick it.
I know when I want to make love to a woman, I always go straight to Daniel Day-Lewis being...
raping Cameron Diaz every chance he gets.
We didn't
you like that, sweetheart?
Did she drink your milkshake?
A different movie.
Different movie, but it's fuck.
But it's the same guy, right?
Yeah. Say okay.
Thank you.
Daniel K. Lewis. We
got a retard robot back there.
Yeah, I think Joel thinks he's on At Midnight right now. He's trying to like get points or something like that. Wow. So MJ, no other fun facts about you? Like you. I feel like there's something else. Your parents weird in any way?
No.
No, normal parents are still together.
Your dad has sleep apnea for real?
Yeah, he does, yeah.
Does he wear that thing?
Yeah.
Why do you woke him up in the middle of the night for real?
I woke him up and I...
Yeah, that went nowhere. He just said, hey, dick, or whatever, and that was it.
Dickwad, and we're all dickwads. I didn't like
Do you have a little dickie? No.
Wait, what? That was, oh my God.
Points.
That's what that was for. MJ.
You say that, buddy.
Interesting. Well, what are some other things that you talk about in other sets that you've done? Like, without doing the joke, like, what's the subject matter about?
Yeah, after the dickwad, it was, we're...
After the dickwad. I love it. You already have a name for your second comedy album. After the dickwad, coming soon from
another,
MJ
Green. Was this another Tinder date from way back?
What's MJ stand for?
Michael James.
Wow.
Mike Graham sounds too much like all my friends say, oh, I'm at Mike Graham's. It sounds like I'm at my grandma's. So I just stuck with MJ.
Wow, Mike Graham.
Okay, but...
That's what I thought of whenever I heard that.
Plus, I have a cousin named Mike Graham, and...
MJ, I feel like you've only hung out with a few people your whole life. And those few people were bad influences on you. They carried stuff around in their mouth and like weird shit like that. And
he was raised by dogs, Tony, okay?
All right. Well, MJ, it was nice to meet you, man.
Likewise,
you have a good spirit. Anything else from Steve Ranazzisi?
No, buddy. Good luck. Where's that burger lounge? Where is it located? Plug it,
Larchmont Village.
Perfect. Whoa. There it is. Check him out. Mr. Personality at the front door.
Hell yeah. MJ Graham, ladies and gentlemen. There he goes. Fuck yeah. We're having fun up here. Meeting some new people. It's exciting. Plowing through it.
I like that guy.
Yeah. Well, he talked slow like you guys, so it's probably because you could understand him easily.
You know it.
All right. Pulled another name out of the bucket. Put your hands together for Stephanie Wayne. Stephanie Wayne. Here we go. She's got a good steady jog. Here she comes. One more time for Stephanie Wayne, everyone.
Hi. Hello, hello, hello. Have you ever felt like such a garbage human that you intentionally stop brushing your teeth for 3 days so that the pain that you feel on the inside becomes like a physical pain that you can smell on the outside? Cool, me neither. My boyfriend of 6 years recently broke up with me at Disney, which is super fun. My parents actually divorced twice at Disney. So I was like, kudos to Gray for keeping it in the family, really honoring like our family crest. I was like, oh, Gray, do you want to go to the Rainforest Cafe where my mom's first marriage crumbled? Like, I think that there's like an automated rainstorm that plays like every 15 minutes that can reflect the monsoon of animosity we both feel towards my affair. I was like, let's make this divorce theatrical.
There you go, Stephanie Wayne. Pretty excited about this. This is the first time we've ever had an actual Lannister on the show before, so I'm pretty pumped. I loved you as all of them. Jeremiah?
She's the cutest. Never mind.
Okay.
She's a cute. She's
easy, buddy.
She's
turn off your event log.
Oh, man. All right, so there you go.
She's the cutest lesbian mom I've ever seen.
Thank you.
Oh, there you go.
There it is.
Thank you. I just came out. That's like so exciting to be recognized.
Congratulations.
Oh, is that true? Wow, yeah. That's easy to do after your boyfriend dumps you at Disneyland.
I was going
to
say, Tony.
I think everyone's a lesbian after they get their heart broken.
Right?
Hello.
Tony, I was going to say, how dare your boyfriend break up with Peter Pan at Disneyland. That is.
It's so wrong.
Hey, I'll take it.
Stephanie, you have an incredible charisma. I love the way that you use the stage and everything. How long have you been doing stand-up?
In L.A., I've been doing it for like 5 months, but I did it in college, and I just took like a writing break. So.
Where'd you go to college?
I went to Penn State. Pennsylvania.
Ah.
Yeah, Penn State.
Wow, that's why you seem so damaged. You're there during the old Sandusky era,
oh
huh?
Oh, my God, yeah.
Beat into a lesbian.
Very much in the thick of that, yes.
Wow, of course, yeah. Interesting. Yeah.
Do you perform often?
Yeah, I try to get up like every other night or every night.
You seem very comfortable on stage. This
I
is
like
a lot of
it.
People.
Yeah, this is great. You give yourself a round of applause, guys.
Like, wow, look at that.
Fuck yeah.
Someone
pandering.
Took,
wow.
Level one improv at UCB. Fuck yeah. Give yourselves a round of applause. Am I right, people?
All right.
Thank you very much.
I'd like to offer you a position at Burger Lounge.
Stephanie, how true is it that you got broken up with at Disneyland?
It's
Am I crazy?
True.
Like, I was trying to, like, figure out what you were talking. I was sort of confused there.
Yeah.
Oh, no, it happened, like, a month ago. Yeah, at Disney. Oh, wow. We were on vacation. Uh-huh.
Wow. And it was this one, Disneyland?
Oh, no, it was Disney World.
Oh, wow. Oh,
Was it, like, a thing where he's like, you know what? You just got into a fight there, and it was like, fuck, you were broken up? Or was it like, I brought you here for a reason? Like, how? I mean, that's what I... Because I've broken up with my wife at Disneyland, too, but we're still together.
Right. I don't,
You know, you got a shot. You still may be in the game. You still like him, or you seems like you went the other way.
We're actually, like, best friends. Like, we're trying to be, like, a lesbian version of, like, Will and Grace.
Whoa,
like,
cool.
We live together. We're best
it's
friends.
A girl.
It's a girl.
No, it's a boy.
What the fuck?
So then how would you be the lesbian version of...
Yeah, he's got a
because
dick?
Because I'm the lesbian and he's the straight one.
You're a lesbian now is what you're sticking with.
Yes.
How long
do you think you've been a lesbian for? Just out of curiosity. I don't know how this stuff works.
Well, like, I've been, like... I came out as bisexual, like, a year ago. And
to him? Of course. That's why you got broken up with.
Yeah.
Hey,
a little too late to like, go by.
It's a progressive thing.
No,
you know?
it's okay, sure.
Yeah.
This guy sounds like a real Tinkerbell.
He does. No, he's amazing. Grayson's like
good
really
shot.
Great.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. So about a year ago, you tell him, I think I might be into women.
Yeah, well, like, I feel like I've always sort of struggled with it, but like, my mom is, that's a, ooh.
There's Tinkerbell.
I do believe in fairies. I do believe in
fairies.
That's
the black swan of Tinkerbells right there.
I think that's the ghost of Savannah flying, flew out of Kiana's pussy.
There's like a lot of fairies on stage right
Whose
now.
Whose pussy?
Kiana, the first comedian that had the Savannah tattoo. The ghost of Savannah, the sweet, sweet Georgia moth. Wow. So you told him that you're into a chick, and that's when he's like, perfect, dude, let's have a fucking threesome, babe. And you're like, no, I'm not that type of bisexual. It's more like my own adventure, and I've been watching a lot of MSNBC, and I've thought of this. And
great, get in the car. We're going to get a churro, and I'm going to break up with you at Disneyland.
Yeah, I mean, my mother is actually gay as well, and so... It was just like a struggle because I grew up in like a very conservative like Pennsylvania town.
Yeah.
And so I feel like we always had to like keep it a secret because like my mom like you know was like trying not to get her fired because she worked in the school district.
Right.
So was it like Handmaid's Tale? Yeah. You guys are crazy.
It is. Yeah.
It really is in Lancaster.
It's like a version. It's like a version of it. And so I feel like I came to California in like my secret dreams. I'm like I'm gonna be gay there.
Jeremiah.
We found out. We found out my mother was gay, and we threw her in the well.
That's what I'm saying, yeah. Pennsylvania.
She probably liked it.
Different strokes.
She did like being thrown into a big hole, though.
You watch your damn mouth.
That's his
a
mother.
A big, wet hole. All right.
You know what? I'll kill you right here in broad daylight.
I wish you would.
Oh my God! Wait a second. Is this a produced piece happening right now? Is
that someone's writing their script?
Stand off, Tony.
Oh, it is a produced piece. Oh, whoa, shit!
Looks like one of them doesn't know where this could go.
The wild, wild west out here. So, Stephanie, when did you find out that your mom was gay?
When I was in, like, fifth grade.
When you were in fifth grade. And your mom and your dad are no longer together.
No.
Right?
Yep.
Were they still together then?
No. They divorced when I was, like, in first grade. And then she came out when I was in fifth grade.
How'd she let you know that? Do you remember where you were?
Yeah.
Was it at the dinner table or something like that?
And
she's like, yeah, this steak isn't all I want to eat. You know what I mean? I'm in a pussy.
I loved, like, my stepmom.
After School Specials by Tony Hinchcliffe.
Or maybe she just left one day and left a note like, hey, going south of Savannah for a little bit.
Yeah.
That's one plantation I'll work on.
What? How'd she let you know? Was that a little bit wild?
Yeah, well, we were actually, I talk about this in my sets, but we were actually like in her bedroom. Melissa Etheridge?
Yeah, Melissa Etheridge was playing
this
in the background.
This is my childhood, you guys.
And you're in your bedroom.
Yeah, we're in our bedroom. And she, like, came out. She came out to us, me and my sister, because, like, I just started shaving my legs. So I was, like, mature enough to handle, like, you know, like, adult conversations because I was, like,
and
a lady now.
And your mom's like, sweetheart, you don't have to do that.
Yeah.
You don't have to shave your legs.
No, but, like, she told me, and then I was, like.
You were
like,
in your bedroom?
Yeah, we were in
Did
her bedroom.
Did she literally come out of your closet?
No. No, that's, like, the set, is that, like, I physically ran into her closet. Because I was so, like, confused and scared.
Oh, yeah.
And I just, like, literally hid there for hours, you know?
Wow.
Yeah.
What were you wearing?
And then she's like, sweet, Brian, stop it.
I was 10. This is appropriate.
And then what happened when, man. And then when she found you, what did she
say? Red Band's extra curious now.
All right.
Did you say inappropriate?
Were you wearing Oshkosh or?
Okay,
you
Brian,
one over the
Brian, 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 Brian. Wasn't, stop it. All right, so then your mom finds you in the closet. What does she say? Like, oh, sweetheart, come here and scissor with your mother, and let's talk about this.
She just, like, left me in there. Like, I feel like her and my stepmom were just like, is this really happening? Like, did she just go into the, like, closet?
And you
she
and
just,
your like, stepmom?
Like, her and, because my step, like, my mother and my stepmom. They
gotcha.
Were there
so
together.
There's already two moms.
Right, her roommate became my stepmom, yeah.
Right.
It's real.
Wow.
It's real.
I just saw Brian type in lesbian music. The fuck? What do you think's gonna
lesbian
pop up
music.
There exactly?
Lesbian never, music, Brian? Like, what are you on Spotify?
He is. He actually
it's the best
is.
Kind of music.
Lesbo.
It's the best.
Something I can run to.
Send me the playlist. I'd be into it.
Oh, my God.
So it's a very incestual family. Like, you guys are all together in it. Then.
Yeah, I was pretty spot on with my Lannister thing to start this,
yeah.
huh?
Yeah.
I mean not, like sex with each other, but you guys
right.
are close. And
yeah.
Anyone that gets in there is like a spider web. You just, you keep them.
Yeah, I think, what do you
this
mean?
This is what popped
sure
up under lesbian music. Very good. More Melissa Etheridge.
Well, the all roommate right. became the wife, the girlfriend then, you know,
oh, yeah,
that's
yeah,
what I'm
yeah.
saying. Everyone that gets
yeah.
close.
Right, we stick together.
Yeah.
You queer community, man.
Oh, yeah,
gotta
lesbians
stay strong.
Tend to stick together sometimes.
Yeah. Scissors.
Wow. So, Stephanie, what's your, you say you still live with your ex-boyfriend?
I do. Mm-hmm.
Is that hard for him to see you just smashing puss while he sits there jerking off all the time? That's one of the coolest, like, fuck yous to a guy that breaks up with you ever. Hey, you know what? It's cool. Why don't we just stay living together? And, by the way, I'm a fucking lesbian now. Does he ever bring a girl home and
we
you just grab her by the hand and take her into your bedroom?
Yeah. He doesn't do comedy, does he? Because we would shred he's him if he came
funny.
Up here and told that story.
Oh, I would
I
love
wish
that.
He would. No, he's super funny, but no, he doesn't. We haven't, like, crossed that territory yet. That's, like, new waters. We haven't, like, dealt with, like, the sleepovers, you know?
Ooh.
Yeah. Yeah, we're trying to figure it out. I feel like there's no, like, guide to, like...
there you
it's
go.
Real, like...
Sixth try, he found a real lesbian music.
I couldn't find a good Kanye song.
It doesn't even make any sense. Wow. All right. Well, we've spent a lot of time with you, Stephanie. You're I love your charisma. You're so likable and cool. I wish I could interview you more and
very
find out
pretty
more
face
stuff.
Too. We really lost one with
thank,
you.
I'm gay, but thank you.
Okay. I don't know what just happened. But Brian might look enough like a lesbian to actually oh, yeah. nail this.
Have you seen these thighs? They'll crush your head.
Wow.
Barf.
Anyway. I think I just watched Stephanie become more of a lesbian.
No. Just shoved her over the corner.
Her vagina's coming out of her ass.
Okay, will you stop? You're not even... Do you have a stroke or something? All right. Well... Stephanie, it was nice to meet you. We'll
yeah.
see you again soon. Come
nice
back
to meet
again.
You,
I want to talk to you more.
Okay,
there she goes, Stephanie Wayne, W-A-I-N. Follow her on Twitter, stayfunny_WAIN. There you go. Wow, wow,
wow. Push it real good.
We're having fun, right? Steve, how you doing?
She was great.
Yeah.
Great energy. And, you know, much better look at than the guy before, so.
Yeah.
Tony, that last girl, she really put the L in lesbian.
Oh, Jesus.
Ellen, get it?
What
Ellen?
The she hell was that? I will fight you right here.
She looked like Ellen, but put the L in. I will fight to the death until this joke works.
You are. All right. This looks like an interesting name. I don't know if we've had this person up before. Put your hands together for Sam Cutter. Sam Cutter. Here we go. Is that Sam? I feel like it's not. I don't see
Blacklisted.
Sam Cutter. No. There you go. What? That's not him, no. People don't walk like the Undertaker to the stage. Alright, let's try this one. Jess Wood. Jess Wood. Oh, there she is, Jess Wood. Hello. Put your hands together for Jess Wood, everybody.
Thank you. I'm really happy to be here, you guys, because I grew up right near here. I grew up about 3.5 miles east of here. And I love watching people come to L.A. and walk around, and they go, oh, my God, a movie was shot here. Because I walk around, and I go, oh, my God, I was shot here. It's a true story. Thanks. I hung out with gang members a lot growing up. Essays. I didn't mean to. They found me at the they found me at my locker, you know, some dude in a hairnet and is fucking up here just buttoned to the top of the flannel. He's like, Jessica, you need to hang out with us. We've been watching you, homegirl. You're fucking crazy and shit. Now this is Froggy talking to you right now. Listen up. I was like, oh my God, Froggy? Does that tattooed tear mean you killed somebody? Because it's adorable. And he was like, yeah, but that was a long time ago. Okay, we're in seventh grade. Oh.
There you go, Jess Wood. If you were going to tell me that tonight there was going to be a lesbian on stage, a girl with Savannah tattooed above her pussy, I would have guessed that you would be both of those people, Jess Wood.
I am. Thank you, I am.
You are?
I am.
You are a lesbian.
No, oh. But I've tried it.
Oh. There you go.
But I like that yeah. dick.
She okay.
Gave it the old taste test, huh?
Yeah.
She looks like she has Portland tattooed above her pussy.
No. Thank you, though, Jeremiah.
Wow, this gaze is striking me my fancy.
Hell yeah. Speaking of gaze, you said that you tried being a lesbian for a bit. What does that mean?
I only tried it one time, Tone. I wish I could say I tried it for a bit.
So it was one night?
Yeah, it was just like the Halloween scare. Like, oh, no. That's okay.
What did you take from it?
Whoa.
Was there anything that surprised you about your lesbian experience?
Might have been your technique.
Yeah.
did you get gay in a haunted house? What was that?
Yes.
Scared straight.
Did anything surprise you that you weren't expecting about being with a woman that night? Wait, yeah, there must have been bees around. We all know about those pesky pussy bees that fly around all the time.
Like Johnny
good
on the
job,
spot,
Brian.
Yeah.
He really nailed it that time.
Pussy bees.
That's fun.
So, what was that like? What was being with a woman like? I don't know.
We talk too much.
Ah.
Yeah, she talked too much. I'm sorry. That sounds woman-hating. I'm sorry.
Was this woman a chola?
No. She was a runaway.
Really?
Yeah.
Maybe she just had a dirty pussy.
No, she needed somewhere to stay.
Oh. Wow, a real runaway.
Yeah.
There's your moment to hit Kanye music if you wanted to.
Poopity poop.
So how long have you been doing stand-up?
For too long to not know you guys.
Too long to yeah. not know
What's the
you.
Math on
but here's
that?
The thing. Like, oh, wow. That was rough. No, really, because I grew up doing a lot of drugs. The PCP stuff is all real. Being shot is real. All that shit is real. I don't really talk about bullshit up here because I've had a crazy life.
Yeah.
So I think for a lot of the times I was doing comedy, a lot of people didn't believe me when I was telling my story.
Right.
So it got me really pissed, and I was kind of gangster in my head, like, well, fuck this club then. You know, and then I'd leave, and I wouldn't come back. So that's good to do if you want to do something for your life.
Yeah.
Just say, fuck it, and leave.
That's right, eh? That's fucking right.
Yeah,
homegirl,
dude,
that's
horrible.
What's up.
Horrible.
Oh.
It's a horrible idea.
Wait,
just
is that shades of Jolina?
That's right, eh? I'm right here, eh?
Oh, wow. We haven't seen you in a while. What made you come out tonight?
Shit, the homegirl right here talking about fucking being all crazy and shit. I'm like, well, let's see how crazy you are, bitch.
Oh, this is Jolina. She gets a little pesky. She's a female Mexican from Los Angeles, and she's been through a lot. Ever run into her? Have you ever seen this girl before?
Man, all the time. I always carry the filero, though. I'm ready for her in the alleys, you know.
Oh, my God.
Man. Yeah.
Stiletto.
You ever get into fights before?
I have.
Yeah, you usually win, don't you?
Oh, Jesus.
Wow, she looked at me like she was about to fucking punch me, by the way, for the podcast listeners.
No.
What's your record?
No,
criminal.
No.
Yeah. At her age, I would guess her record is vinyl.
Ooh, thank you. Thank you. You guys would know, I know. We're all peers.
If you had to guess what your fighting record is, well, what is it? My guess is 7-1. Am I right?
It was groups of people.
Yeah.
So
you ever get beat up?
Yes.
Yeah?
Ooh. Yeah.
What was that like?
It hurts.
She didn't do the dishes.
Oh, God. All right.
Oh, that's right. Sorry, honey. All right, we're improvising.
Give her a shiner real quick.
What do you,
You ever been to jail?
He's so cute.
Good question.
Just in holding cells.
Me too.
Yeah?
That's as far as we got.
That's as far as we got.
Because we're white.
Well, yes, exactly.
I wish I could say the same, but fuck.
I know.
I had my baby in there. It was crazy. Fuck.
In the holding cell?
Nah, I went further than you, homie. I'm crazy, dog.
Had my baby in there.
How the hell did Jolina hack his robot mind?
Jolina, how did you end up getting out of prison?
Well, you know, I fucking, I don't know, some way. I don't like to confirm or deny anything, you know?
Is there any
That's
truth?
Right, girl. That's right.
That's right. It's my lady right here, eh?
That's right. No snitching.
Wow.
No snitching.
Because I heard that maybe there was a guard that put his dick through the bars.
Oh, that puto? Yeah, that fool was like, he was crazy. He touched it in me, but like, whatever.
He touched it? Did
it? I heard that you jacked him off.
I did. I jacked him off.
Wow. Oh, Jess actually beat him to it. That's incredible.
I let her have it, all right?
I don't think Joel realized the beach ball I was blowing up for him there, but obviously Jess has listened to the show.
I haven't
before.
Seen the beach in years, Tony. I'm sorry.
It looks like Robot Jeremiah is even mad at Joel for not catching on to us.
I mean, I saw it from 3 damn miles away. What the hell? I will shoot you right in the temple right here.
Oh, fuck. God damn it. Fuck, that was so funny. All right. Jess,
yo.
What's some other crazy shit that you've been up to? Like, if we were doing like a live interview and we wanted to get like the best out of you as fast as possible.
Okay,
what would
you say? Was the first white chick on Def Comedy Jam.
Whoa!
What?
Yes. Wow!
Yeah. I didn't want to do that bit though because I thought it was hacky.
What? When was that? I love that you're like afraid of your age. Look,
I
we can see your face,
I
lady.
Know, I know.
I don't know what the fuck you should.
No, but saying I don't care
she
about.
She has
age.
The coldest it's eyes,
insane.
By the way.
Yeah,
she can literally be smiling, but her eyes fucking change. She's like
Steve,
one of those
really
White Walkers or something like that when they just fucking flip.
I feel that I'm gonna kill.
Tony,
people.
I also like
no,
that she said she's been doing. She's been doing stand up too long to know who you are, but she knew my joke.
Oh, no, that's true.
I didn't want to say the year of Def Jam because I was embarrassed about how long I've been in the game and haven't been up and doing shit more. So it was 96. So,
there you go. Center There's the answer to the question.
Was my host.
I love that. You're 96 really? Years old.
That's all right. Right. That's right. That's exactly
that's
right.
That's what I was trying to no,
That's exactly right.
Wow, that's fucking awesome.
Yeah, it was great. I mean, no one knew I was a comic. Everyone thought I was a stylist when I got there. So it was awkward, but you know.
How'd you
I
do?
I was okay.
I actually.
Whoa, did they air it?
Steve, I remember.
No.
I actually.
No?
No, they
then
didn't.
Then you bombed.
No, I thought I did really good.
Russell no, Simmons you said did I it. They would have aired it, I think,
Steve,
right?
I actually saw it. Oh, wait, oh, wait, it didn't air? Oh, no, that just ruined my whole joke. Fuck it.
Yeah, it was a joke.
Yeah, it didn't air, bro. They,
no, you know
they always
why?
Don't air the good
Do
ones,
you
right?
Hear
I was
going to
say. I was going to say.
You
I
just
want
to say that I bombed? You don't want to hear
no,
why?
No, I'm just saying I don't think, like, I
Ooh, Jess Wood
yeah,
is
Yeah, I want to go against you. I want to take it to the mat.
Wait, I don't want to fight you, if that's what you're asking.
No, no.
What
because,
is happening?
No, nah, because the Def Jam, they didn't know what the hell. They were, like, so confused because I came out.
Because you were white.
Yes.
Yeah. But nobody asked you, like, beforehand, like, what bits you're going to do or anything
they
like that?
They saw me. They yeah. wrote me from seeing me. I hadn't even done stand-up a year.
Yeah.
And the guys that were casting it saw me kill. But I only killed in urban rooms. They called it urban rooms. Only black
they
and
still
We know what the
they
word
still
urban
still
means.
They
you
still
don't
call
the,
they
still
they
call it
called
that.
It. So yeah. Black and Spanish rooms, I killed. But white people were like, no. You know? So when they did Def Jam, they brought it to Los Angeles in 96 for some horrible reason. And they put us up in Beverly Hills. And everyone in the crowd was a celebrity or a white person. So it was a dead-ass crowd.
Really?
I had a great joke about fighting and with Vaseline, putting Vaseline in my face. And everyone was just... I don't understand.
Are you sure you didn't perform in an actual deaf comedy jam? Perhaps that's why they weren't responding to your jokes. They were deaf. They, as in hard of hearing.
Cedric the Entertainer was my host. He was really sweet. But his introduction to me to come out on stage, he was like, all right, y'all are excited for your next comedian. I know you are, but for your next comic, I want y'all just to keep an open mind.
Oh, God.
That's exactly what he fucking said. That's exactly what he said. That's exactly what he said. I can't make
really?
That up. I can't make any of this up, Jeremiah.
Jess.
Oh, I feel like you were trying to
Tony,
do you a favor. You I bet he thought he was.
Do you have a joke about this? That's so funny.
Yeah, you should say that.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
There it was.
And you don't need to get... Yeah. And you don't need to do all that You don't need
I'm
to do all that stuff on the
man,
front
I'm
end.
I'm trying to shove him in here.
Wow.
Like, you know, you guys were for those girls that got up here earlier. Yeah, that was cute. I like that. I like
Are you talking about Red Band? I wasn't flirting with any of those girls. It was this guy over here. What do you think about him? What would you do to Brian Red Band?
Oh, to your type?
Oh, now you don't want to be all sexual and creepy?
I feel like I made out with you before, though. Have we not made out?
Yeah, we did.
I think we made out.
Okie dokie. Yeah. Anyway, wow. All right.
For real?
What are the odds
of
that?
I've been looking at him for, like, I came here before, I've been trying to get up, and I keep looking, I'm like, I know this fucker, and I usually can't remember, because I fuck so many people, but I think I made out with you, because we didn't fuck, so I remember the
It's a love connection here at the Comedy Store at Kill Tony.
I love that. What are the absolute odds?
No, I'm too old like two for him. Ships in the night. He likes 10 to 15-year-olds.
What?
Right? That's what he said.
No.
It seemed like that earlier.
I don't know what's going on.
If I made out with Brian Redband, I would take that secret to the grave.
You were in the alley, right?
Yes.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Oh, what?
What the
it was
fuck?
10
is
bucks, guys. 10 bucks.
Do you, this is where she reveals
what?
That she's also been mothering his two children.
I smoked a lot of PCP, Tom.
Yep.
Really?
Yeah, with the essays.
What's that like?
It's like being a midget on a cloud. That's what it felt like to me, like a midget on a cloud. But I used to pass out all the time.
Never been on a cloud?
Yeah.
Now that is a specific description.
Yeah.
Yes. It's exactly how it felt. I don't know if anybody's done it, but it feels like a fucking... Yeah, it feels weird. I pass out all the time. I mean, it's elephant tranquilizer, you guys. I don't know.
Are you sober now? You seem like you've got all your shit together.
I like acid.
Okay.
Wow.
Do you have any?
Very honest.
I like acid.
Yeah. Hell yeah.
How often do you do acid?
How often do you do acid?
I did it for New Year's.
Okay.
So
quarterly, I guess?
Yes.
4 times a year?
Yeah. Mother's Day is coming.
Perfect.
So.
Seems like get your best bonnet and acid tab out.
That's right.
Let's go to church.
You just took it at home and stayed there on New Year's?
No, I was fucking this dude and we went to a party. I mean, I wasn't fucking him when we went to the party.
His name is Brian Redband.
We just made the connection.
I wish.
Wow.
Yeah. What else?
Damn.
Wait, you're a mother? Did you say you're a mother?
No. Oh, no. I've killed so many children. I'm sorry.
Wow.
I'm pro-choice, fuckers.
Is that true?
Yeah.
How many abortions have you had, do you think?
Five.
Wow.
Whoa. How many do I think? Like,
where are your sound effects, sir?
How many do you think?
Give me fucking anything on that.
By the way.
Yeah, there you go.
The sixth one's free. I don't know if you still got a shitty fucking eggs
doll.
Left in there,
I get
but
the baby doll too.
You get that punch card. The sixth one's free,
exactly,
sweetheart.
Right. Yeah.
You said that like you performed three of them and just had two of them yourself.
Yeah, you know.
No, I've never met somebody that calls drive-bys abortion.
Jeremiah?
Where I would get that on a t-shirt. I've had five abortions.
Yeah, this could be your new, like, get her done.
Where I come from, they call her the fetus Diablo.
It's true.
Wow. How spread out are your abortions? Like, you know, like my mom herself has five kids, and yeah. I'm the youngest of five, and there's like 12 years in between me and my older siblings, so I'm curious.
It was like three. It was quarterly. Well, like, you know, yearly. You're like four year.
Oh, so you're like a leap year abortion lady.
Yes. Okay. Yes. Yes.
And to be honest, one fell out. You told me that one just fell out.
Oh, yeah.
Wait,
yeah.
What are you guys doing? Your own little troop or something?
That's a starting NBA basketball team.
Yeah. Five human lives.
Or I mean, a variety show.
You have five abortions.
Yes.
You killed more people than the YouTube shooter.
Or I like to say I'm like China, but I don't know if they were all girls.
All right.
Thank you.
I liked mine better.
Well, okay. Everyone did.
No, it's okay.
Because you're the man. Tony.
Thanks, Jess.
Yeah.
Well, congratulations for knowing your body and knowing what you can handle. You know.
Thanks. It's still very delightful in there.
Yeah.
Looks great.
So, thank you.
I don't know. Her vagina might look like Mad Max Fury Road now.
Oh, Jeremiah, you know it's lovely.
All right, I do.
Okay.
Fuck, this is another great interview. I feel like I could talk to you forever.
Thanks, I like it.
Huh. You know it's good when 15 minutes in you find out she had five abortions.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
That's usually headline news, breaking tonight.
Her pussy's had more vacuums in her than a hotel room at the Flamingo in Vegas.
Was that in breaking news?
Yes. That actually, when you hear that, that means that it was actually true. Like, I meant it to be a joke, but then he fact-checked it. The guy that Googles lesbian music.
So expertly.
I wonder what will pop up here. Lesbian music. All right.
Well, was that abortion music?
No.
Jess, you are so much fucking fun. And you know, let me just say that, like, you know, it seems like you have a little bit of a, you're, and I don't mean this in a negative way, like a little bit defensive about how long you've been doing it and things like that. But you shouldn't be, because your interview and everything, I mean, this has been so fucking entertaining.
Thanks.
You're such, your skill set, your fucking experience shows in this part of the show. You know, a lot of people can be funny for 60 seconds once or twice or three times, but to be interesting during this part isn't easy. And we just spent longer with you than I think we've spent with anybody in maybe ever.
Thank
perhaps.
You.
A long interview.
Can I plug my podcast?
Sure. What's your podcast? I'll actually allow it.
I have a podcast called Get Wood.
Get Wood. There you go.
It's an audio diary. That's what they call it. It's a bunch of stories, characters.
Fuck yeah.
It's really fun.
And you seem like you've had an interesting life.
Yes.
There she is, Jess Wood, ladies and gentlemen.
Thanks, you guys.
She's on Twitter at the Jess Wood. Mighty Morphin Power Rangers?
Hell yeah, it is.
Wow.
You know, to be honest, I don't think I really made out with her, but the more we talked, it's like, fuck, did I really make out with this woman?
you make a lot of bad choices right now.
All right. This looks like a new name. Put your hands together for Mike Eshak. There we go. Here he comes. It's like he was ready for this. Just standing there.
Oh, sure.
I'm from Detroit. Are you sure? Used to be the murder capital, now it's cute. This is how much Detroit has changed. There was a spot that I used to go to where I could buy weed from a black guy and a lowrider. Now you go there and you can get sushi from a white guy and a curly mustache. Just the other day, I saw a white girl running, and she wasn't running from anything. She was just running. I was home for the holidays. I was driving through Detroit. I saw cops. We have cops now. Fucking adorable. Thank you.
All right, Mikey Shack. Clocking out of work 10 seconds early there, but you're from Detroit, so we'll allow it. There it is.
I didn't know that it was...
How you doing, Mike? That was awesome, dude. That was real shit. That's great. It's been a big week for you. We found out you don't eat pussy this week, so... Come on, you got that same... beard and
motherfucker, I eat pussy.
I know.
All right.
I love it. That's awesome.
Can I just say...
Not all pussy, though.
Right, not all pussy.
Not all pussy.
Yes,
Jeremiah. Can I just say you are the strangest engine I have ever seen?
You're the strangest Jew I've ever seen.
You got me.
He just call you a Jew?
Yeah, I don't even know what that is.
It's people...
They put the wrong nose on that robot.
Just going straight off the nose. I love it, Mike. Yeah. Detroit train. Jeremiah is a Jew. Christian, but his nose is indeed very Jewish.
100%.
It's a big nose.
Force of truth. Mike Eshek, that was awesome, dude. So
thanks,
you're from
man.
Detroit. How long have you been on stand-up?
A year and 6 months.
Yeah. You just visiting or you live here now?
No, I live here.
How long have you been here?
About 5 years.
5 years. Fuck yeah. What do you do for work?
Right now, I invest in real estate.
Ah.
Yeah. So you get that Rolex Submariner from?
This is from my mom, actually.
Oh, way to make it weird.
You have a lot of family.
I wouldn't buy a watch that expensive.
Oh, okay. It's a nice watch.
Yeah, it's nice.
Your family has money?
We're Middle Eastern, yeah.
I don't think that's the right country, Brian. Jesus. Was that under your lesbian music file?
Yes.
It's Africa. Not Middle Eastern.
Close to Africa. Close.
Yeah, but still, he doesn't know that.
It still has the, you know.
Red Band has the Lion King pegged down to being filmed in the Middle East. He remembers the sand and the rocks. And,
no dirt.
All right. So, Mike, you're investing in real estate. Like, how did you get to that point?
I've been investing in real estate since, like, just before the market crash, like back in 2007 in Detroit.
You seem younger than that. You look younger than you are?
Mm-hmm.
Wow. You're like the opposite of the lady that was up here last.
Yeah.
She's going to fucking kill me.
She's vicious.
I just see a pair of glowing red eyes in the back of the room.
I came out here for work. I was producing a show called Swamp People for like 3 seasons.
Swamp People?
Yeah.
Oh, starring Brian Redband?
Troy Landry. He does look like Troy Landry.
Wow.
What does Swamp People mean? Like, what is it?
Okay.
You're just going to use the whole soundtrack, Redband?
How did you start producing Swamp People? How does that happen? You're in Detroit at the time.
Yeah, where are the swamps of Detroit?
Not only was I like, you know, for a while I was doing improv at Second City, and I also bought a camera when I was coming up. So I just really was like really into making films. I created a web series called The Ed and Mo Show. It garnered like a pretty decent audience, and then I kind of used that to get me a job.
Wow.
And then like 3 years doing that, I was kind of like, fuck this shit. I just want
to fuck these swamp people.
Do comedy, yeah.
What kind of Middle Eastern are you?
The good kind.
Well, that sounds like the bad
really,
kind
really
to me.
Really,
if that is your really answer, you lost me at wow.
Which one?
Saudi Arabian?
No, my family's from Yemen, but both my parents were born in Indonesia.
All right.
Wow. So I have, and most of my family's in Indonesia.
Yeah.
So do you work on railroads or not?
Railroads.
No, it's a different place.
It's a different place.
You're thinking
place,
of Chinese people.
All right.
In our time, we call it Uber.
Forget
Mike,
it.
Mike, you got really mad at me when I made a joke that was in reference to DJ Khaled this week, said that he doesn't eat pussy. I said that you said that
he doesn't eat his
week.
Wife's pussy.
Yeah, I was offended because I really like eating pussy.
So do you have any like special moves that you do when you're with the ladies or anything like that that you could teach us here tonight? Like anything, you use your beard in any aggressive way perhaps? Or
depending on the girl.
Do you do anything like Middle Eastern?
No.
Like?
No, you don't know what that means?
No, I don't know what
you
that means.
You don't know what it means by depending on the girl?
No, I know what it means using your beard depending on the girl.
Oh.
Yeah, I don't know what that
means.
Well,
depending on the girl. Like some girls want it.
Want
some
the
girls
beard?
Don't, yeah.
Do you ever do any Middle Eastern sex tricks, like spread her legs and go like, here comes the airplane into the trade center,
you know what I mean? Like, I make airplane sounds with my dick. I make airplane sounds with my dick.
Wait, what?
I make airplane sounds with my dick.
Oh.
Jesus.
Oh, that's
what do you, I want to hear the beard technique. How's the beard? When the girls that want the beard,
yeah.
What do they get when they want the beard?
You just gotta feel it out. You know what I mean?
No, nope. Again, you're losing me every turn.
Sometimes it's like, you know, you try a little bit like that. You know what I mean?
He's like, you just
see, okay, what, now see how she responds.
You just drag it up,
beard.
Right. And then if she really likes it, you know.
And then what do? Just like,
Yeah.
You say like that,
this
shit, bitch.
This is easier. Like this.
He's like.
Do you ask the girl? Do you want the beard? You want the beard?
No, that's not sexy. You don't ask.
I don't
ask.
Know.
What do you call that trick?
You don't
the
ask.
The head shaking thing you just did. What is that? You have the name
The Brillo pad. The Brillo pad.
Wow.
No, Tony.
You should call it like the Michael J. Fox catcher or something like
Michael
that.
J. Fox.
Tony calls it the magic carpet ride.
yes.
Mike, what are some other fun facts about you? You've been doing stand-up for a little more than a year. You already have a Rolex.
I'm a former U.S. Marine.
Oh, wow.
Thank you for your service. How long did you serve?
You
4 years.
Just goes to show, no matter what kind of blood you have in your body, you can always choose to fight for the correct side. You know what I mean? That was a pro-American joke. And you guys,
USA!
You guys booing
USA!
And hissing
USA! USA!
Day and age.
How is that pro-American and racist at the same time? I don't know how you managed to do that, but...
That's the same thing pretty much now.
I love somebody's like, yeah! Fuck yeah.
It's crazy you're from Detroit because you are Danny Brown.
Danny Brown is from Detroit.
Is that the guy that got choked out?
It's actually going to be the...
Danny Brown will be a guest when we're in Detroit.
When we're in Detroit, September 20-something.
Oh, my God.
Mike, any other fun facts about you? You know, have you had 5 abortions or anything like that?
Nah, man. Just was in the Marine Corps.
Yeah.
It was a good time.
What'd you do when you were in the Marine Corps? Did you go overseas?
Yeah, but no wars.
Oh.
So, it's nice.
Where'd you go?
What do you think, the music's coming from him? The fuck is, what do you think, he's a Bluetooth speaker?
He is a robot.
He just looked at me like I was playing that out of my saxophone.
I know.
He gave me a death stare like, how the hell are you playing this with your saxophone, you dumb Jew?
That's exactly it. You're a talented Jew.
Jeremiah, play Wham. Man.
So where'd you visit?
Mostly in Europe. We did like Malta, went to Israel, and then Spain.
Like a vacation.
Pretty much. Did Barcelona. Did Barcelona, rang in the new year. It was great.
Wow.
Yeah.
Jeez, sounds lovely.
It was a good time. Yeah, no war.
I take back my thank you for your service.
Yeah, exactly. I didn't do shit, bro.
Did you really ring in the new year in Barcelona?
Yeah.
Or were you just on acid with some hippie named Jess Wood? All right, forget it.
I do like acid, though.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
You do?
Not for me.
Yeah. Yeah. No. What's your favorite thing about acid? Throwing it on innocent Middle Eastern girls' faces? That's right, bitches. I'm a goddamn American. Red, white, and blue. Mostly white.
Is
been waiting 11 years to do that acid on a girl trick. Waiting for a Middle Eastern guy to say, oh, I love acid.
I do love acid.
Never happens. And then I do it, and you guys boo and hiss me, all you immigrants in this audience tonight. I don't know. All right, well.
DMT, too. DMT.
Ah, DMT.
DMT is fun.
Wow.
Right?
Wow.
DMT.
Did you learn anything from DMT when you took it?
Yeah, that death is a fun house.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yep, that's what my mother used to say. She locked me in a shed.
Yeah. It was fun, you know what I mean? It's just like it's very colorful and warm. Have you ever done it?
No, never DMT or acid, no.
No. Yeah. Mushrooms?
Mushrooms, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, mushrooms are fun.
Yeah.
How often are you into drugs?
Yeah, like psychedelics, definitely.
Every, like, week?
Almost.
Oh, wow. My goodness gracious.
Oh, that's almost. Cool.
Sometimes I, like, I'll microdose for a while.
Oh, of course.
Yeah.
Downshift.
You seem like you work out a lot, too, huh?
Yeah. Yeah, I try to work out. I got to, otherwise I'll be fat.
Right.
That's how it works.
That's
how
it works, yeah. No, but I got to be really fat. You know what I mean? Like, I used to be... big.
Like hundreds of pounds more than you are now?
I was like 250, 260.
Wow.
Really?
Yeah.
And then the military got you into shape?
Oh, this was after the military. I got even bigger.
Oh, okay. Yeah. You missed it. Huh? You missed that fucking vacation.
Yeah.
All right.
How'd you lose the weight?
Just...
any secrets to it?
Yeah, P90X?
Just didn't P90X. I did that for
only,
a minute.
Yeah. Only
a
joke.
Eating. Yeah, yeah, yeah. just started eating good and shit.
Only eating pussy?
Yeah.
All right.
You burn a lot of calories eating pussy, you know?
How many?
Especially you when the girl can't when you burn fast.
You wear a Fitbit when you eat pussy? Is that what you know?
My Apple Watch. I got the Apple Watch, the heartbeat.
Yeah, I don't care if you came.
Yeah.
Still with 3 minutes of work.
I burned 500 calories.
All right.
This for you, bro.
It was a pleasure to meet you, man. Yeah, well, thanks for doing the show.
Yeah,
fun
congratulations,
times.
Congratulations, man.
Way to do it. Mike Eshak, ladies and gentlemen. MikeFromDetroit.com is his website. He put that on the Twitter line. He also just touched me on his way off stage.
We now have anthrax on us.
It was okay when the blonde lesbian did it, but Mike Eshak just touched me on his way off stage.
Don't breathe in for a couple minutes.
Let's do something fun, shall we? We have a regular that performs every single week on this show. Steve, you haven't gotten to see him before. He's been a regular for like
I've heard he's
six
fantastic.
Or 7 weeks. He sleeps in his car, which just broke down.
Broke down
this
on the way
week,
to
and,
Ice House Chronicles.
And here he is with a new, brand new minute. Put your hands together for the great Malcolm Hatchett, ladies and gentlemen. The crowd roars. Here he is, Malcolm Hatchett, everybody.
What's up? Fellas, you ever get some head so good that your ass start hurting? Got some head the other day and walked away like this. Oh, shit. Bitch took the air out of both cheeks. Other day, I seen a gay dude become tough for a minute and scared me gay. I was walking, I seen a dude like, this gay-ass dude keep looking at. Gay dude was like, who the fuck you talking to? I was like, yeah, nigga, who the fuck you talking to? You ever see a gangbanger hurt himself because he's so strong? Hey, nigga, where you from? Ow! Shit. Black girls say everything but no. You can line them up and ask the same question. They ain't gonna say no at all. Give me some head. Get the fuck out my face.
Go ahead.
Give me some head. Boy, bye. Give me some head. Nigga, lay the fuck down.
Malcolm Hatchett doing it again. Not only a new minute, how about a minute and 10 seconds? Throwing a little extra in there for us. Hilarious, fun times.
How's your car?
Man, that shit... fuck.
Is it dead?
No.
What happened to it exactly?
I was driving on the way to the ice house, and it started. It got weak. Uh-huh. Weak. And then it
what do you mean it got? The car got weak?
Yeah, it was because I was just pressing the gas, and it just got weaker and weaker. Then it started smoking, and the 18 wheel almost fucked me up, but I got off in time.
Wow.
Now I lift the hood up, and there was smoke everywhere. I felt like one of them WWE wrestlers because I was in the smoke like this. When the cars was going by.
It overheated? What did it? What happened?
That's steam. You shouldn't put your face in that, by the way.
I called contact. Yeah, it overheated. It won't crank back up. My friend told me what was wrong with it. It's a lot of shit wrong with it. Yeah.
What's wrong with it, you know?
That shit, if I go over 30 miles per hour, that shit'll go in reverse.
Oh.
Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Nah, wait. It's just that fucked up. It's fucked up. I ain't even got seatbelts. I buckle
up
like this.
I can't go there.
That shit
can't go above 30 miles an hour. I'll never get there. Fuck, dude.
I followed the situation as always on Instagram stories, and we were excited to see that you put a GoFundMe up to save your car.
I didn't even want to do it. Like 10 people hit me up, like, bro, do it.
You put a limit up of $1,000, yeah. And in 2 days you made right over $2,000.
36. I got like
36.
You got a Tesla?
How much Kill Tony fans.
I got a lot of memo.
Yeah, $3,600 and.
Oh, good for you guys.
He made more than we made reading that Mother's Day Valentine's Day ad this last week.
We don't think we made anything on that.
He made $3,600 more than we did on that.
So are you going to buy like an SUV or something more comfortable to sleep in?
No, I'm going to just buy a gas saver, like a Honda or a Volvo, something cool. Good on gas.
Do not buy a Prius, please.
I might just buy a coat and go back to selling drugs.
Oh, shit. There he goes.
It's an expensive coat, but it'll up your profile.
I love that. So you're going to get a new car, and things are going good for you. I don't know if you want to talk about it, but I'm going to bring it up anyway. I happened to find out last week that you got signed by a major agency, major agency. Oh. Which is, by the way, for those of you that don't know anything about show business, is absolutely unheard of. It is unheard of to still be at the level of sleeping in your car and being 7 months in and being signed by the biggest agency. In
Congratulations.
LA. One of the biggest ones.
Yeah. That was so cool. You have that going for
so
you.
We get
you have to get 10% of that GoFundMe to your agent, though.
It was cool, though, because I went up there for the first time and like made it official, and I knew I had kind of made it because they had fruit in the hallway. And that shit was real. It wasn't fake at all. I called my mom. I was like, they got real fruit. She said, baby, you made it. Now send me $100. But yeah, for real though.
That is awesome.
Real bananas. Damn.
What's your mom like? She a cool lady?
Yeah, she cool. She like a little bit ghetto version of Oprah and Madea.
Does she watch
wait,
this?
Wait. When you say ghetto, you mean a little bit more ghetto?
No,
or?
Well, like, she like Oprah when, like, white people around. And then she like Madea when it's time to get...
Oh, I see.
When she could be herself.
Yeah, she... If I be telling her about it, she'd be like, baby, it sound good, but I don't be in all this social media shit, so...
Right.
Yeah. But I think my brother showed her, like, some episodes, but she don't even know how to text. Yeah.
Right.
She be tripping now.
Yeah. Did she raise you on her own?
Well, my dad died when I was in the fifth grade.
Oh, really?
So, yeah.
I didn't know that. That's interesting. Yeah, how'd your dad die?
Diabetes.
Whoa. Ooh. Shit.
You got to watch out then.
I'm already dead. I'm reincarnated. All my friends are dead.
Man. How old? You were in fifth grade. How old was he when he died?
He was like 50-something.
Wow, 50-something.
I thought you were going to say 22 or
two
something.
Quarters.
Man, you better start eating the fruit at your agent's lobby.
No, don't want to eat the fruit.
Well, no, you would eat that fruit. That's good sweets.
Yeah, that shit real, though.
I think you'd probably know more about diabetes
Where's
than
Dean
me.
Where's Dean
Delray? All right. Well, Malcolm, that's fun. Anything else exciting going on in life?
I've been in the studio dropping hits.
Really?
What? Yeah,
you've been in a real music studio?
Yeah, I just did a song with this dude named Straight Life. I didn't do a song. I just did like a little goofy shit.
Oh, cool.
What's the goofy shit you do?
Just like talking on it. Like, yo, this shit fire, man. Y'all check it out.
So you're the hype man for this guy? Yeah. The greatest job in the world.
It's so good. I'm going to share it later.
Look at Flavor Flav.
And then I did another song called Bald Headed. I was talking about girls with no
hair. I heard it. I love it. It's hilarious.
It's about girls with no hair?
Be cocky girls, but they ain't got no hair. And the whole time I'm just saying, lay down, lay down.
It's on SoundCloud.
Yeah.
That's hilarious.
It's great.
Man, that's fun. Yeah, someone once told me that Nicki Minaj has, like, nothing left up there. I guess there was once a lady who she was mean to, but the lady was the hairstylist. Mm. And the hairstylist was the one that had to, like, you have to, like, attach the wig to, like, this one little tiny piece of hair that she has left. You think there's any truth to this, Malcolm? Are you close enough to Nicki Minaj to know anything about this?
Hell no, I don't know nothing about
that. Not yet.
But I think you will be.
How did you feel about this minute this week?
Oh, it was cool because I drank a Faygo soda before I came up here.
Oh, okay.
Oh, great. Following in your father's footsteps, yeah. I see.
Oh, shit, that's true. Your favorite Faygo is cotton candy flavored Faygo.
Oh, no. We got to fucking
So
get
the
this
die
right.
was cast before you came out here? You didn't really care how the set went. You drank a Faygo soda. You're good to go.
It gave me wings. Oh, my God. Yeah, I feel good. It's cool. Everybody cool.
Awesome. Well, life is on the up and up. You are one of the, I mean, in my opinion, one of the coolest things happening in the world right now. I think it's great for veterans of comedy and for new people of comedy to get to see somebody like you being positive, doing the work, writing in, during the day, performing
living in his
at
car.
Night, living in his car for now.
How many spots
drinking
is this?
Faygo.
How many times has this been for you on Kill Tony, do you know?
I think like 8 or 9.
Eight out of 8 times you've killed it. You haven't had one bad set yet. That's amazing.
Yeah. Yep. There he goes, Malcolm Hatchett, ladies and gentlemen. He did it again.
Faygo with fruit. Faygo with fruit.
Yeah.
Faygo with fruit.
I wonder.
Yeah.
I wonder if he's ever going to have that one bad set. It almost seems like he's not. It's impossible for him.
Well, Jesus, easy.
I mean, anything can happen on any given night.
Want to do one more time?
Yeah, definitely. Let's do it. You guys want to keep going?
Yeah.
I gave a polite nod in the front. I like that. Put your hands together for Jerome Tennyson.
Anything.
Jerome Tennyson.
And blacklist. Nope. There he is.
Okay. Jerome Tennyson, everyone. Come on.
Yeah. What's up, Comedy Store? Happy to be here. It's Teacher Appreciation Week. I'm a high school math teacher. That's right. I'm a pillar of this community. My friends find all the time, they ask me, like, am I afraid of, like, school shootings? And I tell them, hell yeah, like, these kids are crazy. Like, I have my eye on one kid already, like, he's not even in my class. I just saw him in the hallway. I was like, this kid would shoot all this up. So I'm, like, friendly with him. Like, I invite him in my class, like, during lunch. We play Fortnite, just, like, hang out. I'm like, you got a friend in me. Because in my mind, I'm like, if I'm nice to him now, if he starts shooting up the school, he'd be like, and stop. He'd be like, Mr. Tennyson, is that you behind the desk crying? And I'd be like, yeah. He'd be like, go on and get out of here. You got a friend in me. And then now they want to give, like, teachers guns. Like, I don't want no gun. I know I don't. Being a black male, like, can you imagine, like, a school shooting happened? I go grab my gun, run in the hallway. The police like, there he is. Take him out. I got to hold a kid hostage, like,
Fuck yeah. Jerome Tennyson. Fucking killing. There you go.
Nicely done. Nicely done.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
That was awesome. You are the funniest member of the Migos that we've ever had on. That's fun, man.
Great.
Is this your first time on the show?
No, I've been on here 4 times.
Yeah,
I'm 4 for 4. I'm catching up to my uncle.
Shit, I love it.
Is that a true story about the kid? Like, what made him seem more like a school shooter? Because I feel like that's
well, first
what I
of
would
all, he's in high school and he had like a lunch pail.
Oh,
so that's one thing. And then he just kind of had like he just I don't know. I can't really describe the look, but it's like something where you see it, like you keep an eye on like somebody like.
Fuck yeah, there you go. He always plays this song for the 4 people that get it in the main room. So, Jerome, what else is going on in life? How long have you been on stand-up?
2 years now.
And all in L.A.?
Yeah.
What do you do for work? Oh, you're a fucking math teacher.
Yeah, I was like, what the fuck?
How long have you been doing that for?
This is my second. This would be like my first school year, so like 1.5 years, though.
Okay. And what grade are you teaching?
Right now, most of my students are seniors, but I have one freshman class.
That's fun.
You have any 18-year-old girls that are really hot? And you're
oh,
like,
you are disgusting.
I knew we were going there.
Yeah,
do you,
I knew
do
we
you
were
have
going
any,
there.
Any 18-year-old girls that are hot?
I mean, you know, they're...
I mean, this is on the internet.
By the way,
just give us a wink.
If you didn't pick it up,
it's the wrong answer.
I don't want to get in trouble yet.
The answer was absolutely yes, by the way.
If an 18-year-old girl leaves Brian Redband's house at 8 a.m. and is driving 35 miles per hour, how long until he catches up with them and locks her in his basement?
You said 35 miles an hour. She's pregnant.
Oh, wow. Jerome, what is your love life like?
It's good, man. Yeah, I have a girl. We've been together 6 years, 5 years.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's interesting. Where'd you meet her at?
College. We met in college.
Where was college?
UC Riverside.
UC Riverside. She's a white girl, black girl?
Black girl.
Black girl.
Yeah.
Wow. Aphrodite loves that.
Jesus. Afro?
I love that we call her Afro for sure. Yeah, Afro. Oh, get it together. Miss Dite.
Have you ever tried a white girl before?
No, I haven't.
No?
There it is.
Wow.
They're right there.
Aphrodite is what we call a purebred.
Really?
Purebred.
Never once a white girl?
Huh?
Never a white girl?
Never a white
girl.
Wow.
Has the thought ever crossed your mind?
Not really, but I don't know. I'm not going to say I never thought about it, but I just never have.
Wow. One time,
I mean, you know, this white lady is very angry right now.
I know, she is pissed.
Jerome, you can pull out your dick from where you are and fuck her with it if you want. We can take care of this right now. Oh, this guy would like to get in the middle,
obviously.
Way of
that.
Yeah, he's out of here.
I want you to shove it in his ass.
Me first.
He's pissed.
Not paying any
attention. He didn't know she liked black dudes. He's like, I'm out of here. Like, one time I bring you somewhere.
One time I thought about making love to a black woman, but then I went to church and asked God for forgiveness.
You don't know what you're missing out on, man.
That was actually Jeremiah talking, not his character.
Okay.
have you been with Latino or Asian or anything else except or you
mix? So like Latino and black mix.
Oh, yeah. Light skin.
We call that a witch doctor.
Witch doctor. Jerome, what do you do for fun when you're not teaching or doing stand-up?
Let's see, man. I recently got into, like, kayaking and stuff.
Fuck
what?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
Wow.
Girl.
That
LA
is,
River?
That is extra, extra dangerous when you don't know how to swim.
That is true. That is true.
Wait, you don't know how to swim?
I know how to swim.
Oh, okay. Thank God.
Tony was being racist.
He was. But yeah. It's okay. He was. It's his show. Sorry.
Prove it.
Where do you kayak in Los Angeles?
No, the last time I went kayaking was Catalina. I was in went to Catalina.
Oh, okay.
Wow.
Well, I've never been there. It's an island, right?
But you've never dated a white woman before.
Nope. That might be the first step, kayaking.
Wow. This whole math teacher thing is not adding up for you.
Usually a white woman teaches you how to kayak. It usually goes the other way.
Nah, there was a the person you rented from was a white woman. Like
oh,
to rent the
well,
kayak.
Did you fuck her?
No, I didn't.
Ah, all right.
But I probably would have got a discount.
Off the list. We talked at the same time.
We did. That was weird. No. That was weird. But at the same time, it was cool.
Right. It happens.
Now, what kind of like race of porn do you enjoy the most?
Oh my God.
Do
Ryan.
I enjoy the
I just
want to
know if you've never dated a white girl, maybe you like white girl porn.
White girl porn is cool. That's fine. Yeah.
That's your.
Let me ask you this. Do you like student teacher porn?
No. You know what? You know what's crazy? Is one of my coworkers, a teacher, got caught watching porn in class.
Whoa.
What?
Yeah.
Looks like the student. Isn't that crazy?
This just happened. This happened like last month.
What was he? He was looking at it on his phone.
He was. I guess he was looking at it on the computer, and one of the students asked to use his computer.
Yeah.
And he had it up, so she hit a button or something.
Oh.
And the projector and everything was up.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, that's crazy. And oops. So when he got caught, like, we had to have a meeting or whatever.
Oh,
yeah.
Really?
I bet
and
you
so,
did.
Yeah. So they didn't tell the teachers what was going on, but, like, it was rumored. It was like, somebody got caught white watching porn. I was so nervous on my way to that meeting.
Wait, have you watched porn on your phone at work?
I have. Before. I have before. Lunchtime.
Hell yeah.
Fuck, man.
Which teacher? What was that teacher teaching? Was that like the phys ed or something?
No, they was teaching AP stats. So I had to pick. It was only like 3 weeks left of school, but I had to pick up his class.
Wow. One of his AP classes. Stats.
Statistically, he has a very good chance of being a child molester.
That's a weird thing, because if you get caught as a teacher looking at porn and fired,
right.
your job's pretty much over. All the like school that you went to, and like, you're not going to get
everything.
Fired.
Yeah.
That's pretty fucked
up. Reason for leaving previous job.
I think they gave him like paid leave for now, so I don't know.
Paid leave?
Yeah, because you know you got like the union protection, so he has investigation and all that kind of stuff. So
wow,
he's still getting paid right now.
Fucking interesting. Dude.
Summer started early for him.
Hell yeah. So
do kids play pranks on you? Like, you know, like when we were a kid, we always had fart bombs and all that shit. Like, what's the pranks the kids are doing nowadays?
No, but I like occasionally like kids do like crazy. Like I had a kid throw a stapler across the class.
Whoa, that's not a prank at all.
No, but or they thought it was funny.
Wow.
Yeah, they thought it was funny. And it was like the comedian was like laughing, but then I had to give
but
him
the
whole.
But you had to be serious, right?
Yeah, I had to
okay,
give
so
him
the let's say on the, let's say were you facing the chalkboard? You were facing the other way?
No, I was helping another student, so my back was to
okay,
the rest
so
of the class.
Okay, so let's say your back was to the stapler throw?
Yeah.
Okay, so let's say the class was over here and the stapler came from the audience.
Okay.
Facing them, show them what you did exactly.
All right.
So you're teaching the kid, and then the stapler comes.
And I turned around. I was like, "Who threw that?" That's what I said. You know how I found out who threw it? Because I really didn't see.
Oh.
There's this kid. Like I know my students very well. So there's this one kid. I knew damn well he didn't throw it. Yeah. But I blamed him, right? And so when I blamed him, and then I act like I was about to write a detention slip. And I waited for a second, and he looked over at the kid that really did it. He was
right.
like, "Oh, you just gonna let me?" And I was like, "I knew it was you. Come here."
Got it. Oh, wow.
That's like awesome. That.
Psychology.
Fuck yeah.
Back door.
The old fucking stapler fucking detention slip trick. Wow.
Oh.
Fuck. I used to be a bad student. I used to be mean. In fact, I once had a teacher get caught watching porn, and that's when I was in school, by the way, which is really hard.
Really?
So check this out. One day we were on a bus trip back from, we were visiting the Cleveland Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. I think I'm in like 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th grade, somewhere in there. And we're on a bus trip, but it was a fancy enough bus to where they had the TVs at the time, which was like fucking like spaceship shit to us.
Yeah, they were like the tube TVs.
yeah. And but you had to put it on an actual VCR. It was still no DVDs yet. And so he had a VCR in it. It was supposed to be like fucking Titanic or some shit or some like Free Willy or something like that. And obviously he had recorded halfway into it. Back then you would record porn if you ordered it back on a regular tape. And it just went right into it. And you should have seen this guy stumbling and bumbling trying to get up in the VCR like, stop, while the kids, me and my friends literally almost died that day laughing. I mean, at a porn being hot on that bus ride.
What an idiot.
It was unbelievable. Mr. Mancini,
did he
Youngstown,
lose his job?
Ohio. Never forget. There
Mr.
you are.
Mr. Mancini.
Hell yeah.
Did everybody pass?
Yeah, I've never like, I've almost like got kind of caught a little bit. So like, you know, like texting other comics. And sometimes we send like funny stuff to each other. This comedian sent me like, it was like a real short clip. But it was like with the porno noises. Wow. And so I opened it in class. I know my phone wasn't down. So it kind of just made the noise like real quick. Like it was real.
What
really
did you
quick.
Do? Did you do like the old fake cough? Like,
yeah, I did that. And then I just, I was like, I don't know whose phone that was in here. But you need to turn that down.
You start writing somebody a detention slip for it.
Now, like when I grew up, all my teachers were molesting all the kids. Yeah. Like our gym teacher molested
back
four kids.
Back in the 1930s.
Yeah. But is there any teachers that you're like, that's definitely that
There's a couple. There's like a couple that I'm, for sure. Like, and I try to tell like some of my coworkers, but they think I'm just like being like judgmental. And I'm
right.
like, no. Like,
yeah, all of a sudden.
And I think one of the security guards. For sure is.
Wow.
Whoa.
Because he'll come get like a student, like he'll come get her out of class, like, oh, I need to take her to the office or whatever.
The security guard?
He's always riding with her on his cart and everything. Dude. It's like,
Holy
I'm pretty sure. I mean, I can't prove it, but.
Homeschool.
Well, I'm pretty sure we're going to find out what happens in the court case since you just said it on a live podcast. Jeremiah Watkins?
The greatest life lesson I ever learned. was my teacher spit tobacco in my mouth, punched me in the nose, walked away and said, life is hard. And that was the last day I saw my father.
It's a great story.
Jerome, it was a very, very, very hilarious set. I hope you'll come back and hang out with us again sometime. There he goes, Jerome Tennyson, ladies and gentlemen. He's on Twitter at Is That Oklahoma? Mike from Detroit.com at the Jess Wood. Stay funny, Wayne. Wow. I'm sorry we couldn't get through more comedians today, guys, but these were some amazing interviews we had tonight. The great and powerful Steve Ranazizi was with us
through
the whole
thing.
Thanks
for having me.
Make sure you check him out in Charlotte, North Carolina at the Comedy Zone in 2 weeks. Very fun club, very fun guy. All that's happening as a new fantasy football podcast coming out this fall. And check out the 50 episodes up of Hear Me This Book. I did one of them. Kill Tony.
Tony's on one of them. Stephen King's on writing.
Check that out. Thank you so much, Steve.
Thanks for having me, buddy.
Speaking of guys with great podcasts, Jeremiah Watkins of Jeremiah Wonders fame was unbelievable tonight, wasn't he? Huh? Everybody wants to race off and leave without paying goddamn respect.
Thank you. Yeah, listen to Jeremiah Wonders. Malcolm Hatchett was my guest last week. Steve-O is the guest this week from Jackass. Yeah.
He's going to be with us in Las Vegas, Nevada this Friday. Some tickets still available for that. I can't believe it. I don't know what people in Vegas
get
are doing.
Get the combo pack tickets so you can see Kill Tony and then see guys like me and Joel and Malcolm and some other guys be doing like some stand-up or whatever, too.
Malcolm was supposed to be a surprise, but there you go.
Yeah, thanks a lot.
Chroma Chris, anything out there?
Whoops, error.
That gosh darn robot.
Follow me on social media at Jeremiah Standup.
How about one more time for the great and powerful Jeremiah Watkins, huh? Stone Cold Killer. Chroma Chris, what's going on?
Just follow me on social media, Chroma Chris.
What'd you think of tonight's episode, Chris?
Tony, it's pretty good tonight. I liked it. It's a good one.
There you go. All the personality in the world from Chroma Chris. Joelberg. Joelberg, say something, you bastard.
Oh, yeah. We'll be in Vegas. Follow us. Love you guys. Shout out to Ryan J. Ebo. We miss him.
He's on Instagram and Twitter at Mostly Sorry.
Is that the drummer from one of those Chuck E. Cheese bands?
Believe he performs at Chuck E. Queso.
Oh, damn.
Vegas, and the 5-year anniversary, and all those fun places that we're doing stand-up. Take your For Hims vitamins while going to ZipRecruiter.com and using Kill Tony for everything. Kill Tony's in Michigan are on sale, Texas.
Get the new shirt. Get the new Kill Tony shirt, guys.
Yeah.
We're going to start bringing them here, too, so you guys can just buy them here
so
also.
Yeah, get them after the show. You can wear them here, have fun, and everything else. Tickets still available for the stand-up shows in San Francisco.